What's going on there? It is Kolosalus here. Welcome back to another Heroes of the Storm video. Today we are taking a look at Malfurion. In this video, I really want to say it's kind of like a follow-up to a guide that I wrote on Heroes Nexus. I do these guides from time to time. I just try to explain how to play certain characters or, you know, what abilities, what talents to pick, how to use them, in what way, how to support your team or how to deal damage, just that kind of jazz. Also, today marks a very special day for myself as I started to kind of do exercises for, like, you know, for a clearer speech. And so from now on, the commentary should be, first of all, more engaging, and second of all, much clearer and better for you guys to enjoy. So without further ado, today we're taking a look at Malfurion, a character that was reworked recently, and he actually got the longer end of the stick from the rework, just because there was a certain functionality added, which I'm going to explain once we get into the game, to his innervate, to his trait, and it's just proven to be crazy, along with a few other changes that happened to his kit. So without further ado, let's just take a look at him, shall we?
Balloon. Grant us strength.
Alright, boys and girls, we find ourselves on the Forehead Junction. Let's look at our team. Mana. Therefore, we're gonna go Shando's Clarity. So what our trait does, why is it so overpowered? Well, it is overpowered just because the mana part, you return 20% mana, okay, that's fine. But then, while affected by Innervate, their basic ability cooldowns recharge 50% faster, which means you will be cutting them by a third, which means you'll be cutting a third off of their cooldown. It's just crazy. When you put it on somebody, you know, like, I don't know, Li Ming, Alarak, like we have here, Nova, they can get their cooldowns, their snipes, their orbs, everything, just a third quicker, which is just great, great. Our Q ability is called Regrowth. I basically heal my ally for a little initial amount, and then I also give them like this heal over time for 15 seconds. That's just going to heal them. It's very similar to how healing works from a healing fountain. Nothing too specific about that. The only thing you have to note that it was changed in a way that, you know, it has lower cooldown now, and also its healing was increased, but it was actually put over more time, so it proves to be like less healing over time. That's all you had to know. W ability is called Moonfire, and what it does is just little damage in an area very, very, very far range, and also. Does that kill? Oh my god, that's not a kill. So deals damage, and then is going to reveal the enemy for 2 seconds. Nothing too interesting there. A lot of people like to go for Moonfire now, just because Malfurion's healing is so good on its own. I'm not a big fan. Not a big fan of just going for Moonfire. It can, as I said in the guide which I mentioned before, it can make you run out of mana fairly quickly, rather quickly. So, of course, there are talents that help that, but why would I want to spec for something if I'm a support, right? I'm supports. I'm supposed to be supporting my team. That's the entire reason I'm here. You know, maybe in quick match it's not the biggest deal if I'm not the support that the team needs, but when it's like competitive and everything. It actually matters. Alright, so I'm gonna try to run in place with my E ability. It's called Entangling Roots, and what it does, it basically creates this area that kind of grows from the middle. And if anybody walks into the kind of grass area, you can say, they get rooted. So right here, I'm gonna try to root. Actually, he dodged that perfectly. I'm gonna give our Innervate to our Nova. And it's going to root them. If they walk into the grass, it's gonna root them for 1.5 seconds. That's about it. Oh, shizzle my nizzle. Our Nova actually just died because she was trying to put down the nuke. I was trying to heal her, but as you saw there, I just exposed one of the biggest like weak sides. One of the biggest downsides to playing Malfurion, which is his slow heals. You know, he heals for a lot, but it actually takes a while, for him to heal. So I'm gonna heal him, and you can see I cannot actually out heal the burst damage that this what's his name, Falstaff, was doing to our thrall. So again, you kind of have to watch how to do. You just pre-heal people. When you cast a regrowth on a fully healed hero, it kind of just replenishes their health whenever they take damage for the next 15 seconds, of course, because that's the duration of their ability. So it's actually super awesome thing. You can actually pre-heal allies, and also you can give them mana while they have full mana, and then it's just going to give them the passive, you know, passive reduced cooldown of the abilities. Now, it's true, it's actually going to secure his living. I'm gonna pick up the globe. So playing Malfurion is a lot about prediction, right? You want to predict where the damage is gonna go. I know that he's probably gonna be taking some damage from those towers, so I'm just gonna pre-heal him. You can see the healing kicks in right after he took damage. Pretty simple when you think about it, but it's actually it gets kind of tricky when you're preparing for a team fight. Let's see how much CC the aim team has. Pretty much none. So I'm probably gonna go something like a mule. Hold on, mule. Let's go mule. So in that sense, we can. It's actually a different talent in that I did, you know, in the guide. But whatever. It's just something that is gonna be useful on this map. Again, nukes deal a little bit of damage, but that damage, you know, usually doesn't stick that much. I don't know why I called out that mule there. Don't even ask me. I haven't used that ability in a while, so. God damn. Looking like a goddamn noob over here. I promise, I played him before. I played Malfurion before. I'm gonna heal him. And actually, 2 seconds up until our Nova can get a heal. And we're fine. So I'm gonna go top, try to grab two of those nukes, and maybe get some potion for a friendly team. At level 4, what did we pick up level 4? We picked up Alun's Grace. I'm not sure if I explained our first talent. Right, so our first talent. I hope that the root's gonna kick in soon. It didn't. He just kind of dodged it again. Right, there's a heal. There's the D for him. So our level 1 talent reduces the mana on our trait. Not the mana, what the hell. Reduces the cooldown on our trait by 10 seconds. So from a 30 second cooldown becomes a 20 second cooldown, which all of a sudden just kind of gives us a lot of mana and cooldown reduction to give him. Like, I haven't seen any of my allies going back for mana yet. And again, he dodges my that's a kill on for the enemy team. I'm gonna try to just walk through that, give him the heal, but looks like three people there is gonna just be a little bit too much. I'm gonna try to dodge that nuke. Ooh, nice ancestral is actually going to save the enemy Falstaff from falling. And you see, I haven't been using too much Moonfire, and I still haven't went back for mana. So as long as you keep it in check, it should be fine. I feel like for this game, I kind of want to go. I don't know why is he staying. I mean, he didn't die. So I think I'm gonna go Twilight Dream just because they have a little bit of. I feel like. They really want to overextend into me. So what it does, in a little area, what it does, it's just going to silence enemies for 3 seconds, which is actually a huge slow. Oh, freaking shit. That's the copy of mother freaking troll. Go! Go! No! Okay, she's gone, I'm fine. I'll be fine. He's gonna be chasing me. I don't know why she revealed herself. God damn it, Nova. Right, let's call down Mew on the bottom. Is it going? Yeah, it's going. Yeah, man. Let's go back for mana. I'm not sure why I didn't go back there straight away right there. It's fine. It's all good. We have a nuke for ourselves, so I'm thinking you should never nuke the middle lane. So I'm probably just gonna go freaking bottom, because it looks like that's gonna get pushed pretty hard. The enemy team is collapsing on our friendlies, and it looks like they'll be pushed into the enemy fort and ripped! God damn, I don't even want to be in their skin right now. Enemy team doing the camp right there. I'm gonna try to wait for that Falstad to get away from here. And then maybe nuke the bottom. Yeah, so you can see, you can use your E, you know, for situations like that where you have to get away from a friend, from an enemy unit. We can poke at him, but we won't be able to do too much to him. God damn it, boys. Looks like we are killing the enemy team, which is good. So I'm just gonna leave. I'm just not even gonna defend that because there's nothing to defend anymore. And looks like I'm just gonna rotate. Our Nova looks, she's fine, but I'm just gonna give her mana while she's here. Try to clean this up before I get away. And looks like we're gonna be nuking the top lane all of a sudden. So let me get over there. Let's have a range. I feel like probably Shrinkray is gonna be good against that Thrall. I really like Thrall. I really like Shrinkray. I got you heal, boys. Got you heal. All that healing that you need. My god, I just healed a minion. That was good. All that healing, you know, to minions and friendlies, man. I got it. Right, I'm not even gonna waste a nuke on this. I'm just gonna... Yeah, let them come in. Boom. Yeah, boys. Where you popping? How's it popping, bro? Oh, shit. Okay, that was a good fear. That was a really good fear. You don't even want to chase me, bro. Let's go! Oh my god, I got away. I got away. I'm sorry, Alarak, but I had to just save my own fucking ass right there. Okay, he's overextended. Oh god, okay. Okay. Is he gonna die? God damn it, he died, but we lost our throw in the process. I go down. I mean, I was trying to bait him, but he looks like he doesn't want to just bite down on it. It's fine. It's fine. Oh god. Keep up the healing. God damn it, minions, get away from me, so I can mount up. I'm gonna go with my Thrall. Gonna try to do the thing. Try to play the video game the right way. Maybe give him a little bit of healing. Oh shit. Alright, we can actually fight this. Okay, we can't fight this. I need some help. Get away from me. Oh no, I'm sorry. I didn't heal you in time. Okay, let's heal the Alara. Let's do the thing. Where we press Q and we just heal. Okay, let them come in. Okay, that's the kill. I think so. I think that's the best thing that I can do. But now I'm just gonna bail. Tenacious Roots is gonna be my choice at level 16. I was actually told by some people on Reddit, where I actually did post my guide to as well, that it's actually much more useful. I started testing it, and it is in certain situations. So that's what we're going to be trying for today. Anything. Basically, all the things that I'm saying right now, they'll be written down in the game. I mean, not, you know, besides the sucking part, right? That's where I'll be... Right, let's go. It's fine, I got you. What? I'm getting stuck between you guys. Okay, I'm going to go bottom. Oh, shit. Can I heal this? Okay, let's heal this. And I'm going to... try to nuke bottom, and maybe grab the nuke as well. Right, there's the nuke, it's fine. There's a second one coming down, that's also going to almost going to secure it. Going to grab that nuke. Right, so let them have it. I mean, I'm gonna let my friendies chase this. Oh my god. He goddamn picked an earthquake. Alright, that was a good fear. This Alarak is in trouble. Gotcha, bruh. Yeah, let's do this. Oh, the enemy Abathur actually going for the right thing. He's doing the right thing. Looks like we're gonna get this, and we can also get a free nuke from that Gul'dan who just fell. And I'm gonna rotate. I'm gonna actually use this on this. I'm gonna do the thing. I'm gonna try to do the thing, but it looks like it won't matter. It won't matter a thing. As you see, Malfurion not the best person to clean up lanes, to pick up camps and stuff. Especially with this build. I mean, if you want to be kind of not non-supportive and just be selfish, you can. You can go for the Moonfire build and stuff. But other than that, like, you know, when you go for the full kind of a supporty build, you kind of you're not capable of doing too much by yourself. You're just there to kind of to clean up stuff for the friendlies. And you know, of course, I just provide BC. Okay, now we're gonna be actually engaged on by the enemy team. I'm gonna try to do as much healing as I possibly can. There's the root cone on the enemy Gul'dan. I'm gonna basically root him in place. We're gonna get this fort. Okay, there's the shrink rate. Guys, okay. She actually saved me. God damn, that was good. Okay. I mean, it's fine. I mean, I'm not gonna mind. I'm not gonna mind that too much if you just save me from your damage. I mean, if that was me, I would have killed Malfurion first. Oh god, this thrall is in trouble. That did not root. God damn it! I thought I'm gonna get the root and we're gonna get the kill for sure, but that wasn't the case. What I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna try to nuke these tier one structures here. Sometimes I'm just gonna do this. And that's hopefully also going to hit the back minions. Yeah. Looks like Xul, Thrall and Nova are doing the boss. I'm just gonna help them. Why not help my friends? Yeah, I come with the helps. I do help my team sometimes. Oh god damn it. Get it from here, goddamn bastards. Dude, you don't have to heal. You got mana. You got everything, man. Yeah. I don't know where I got that ghetto accent from. Dude, he's alone. I guess we just don't want to capitalize on somebody being out of position, that's fine. Oh god damn it, I dismounted. It's fine. I've said it's fine so many times. I mean, pursue this crap, bro! Okay, so here's... Oh, that's actually a nice gust. I'm gonna try to actually mount up. There's a healing. And just to kind of straight away heal up that damage that was dealt by the enemy Fulstead. Let's camp these minions, it's fine. Let's see. Just put it down there, it's fine. Looks like we did pick up the bottom four. Is that keep or a four? I think it's a four, so it's fine. So we picked that up, that was nice. It looks like we're gonna be, you know, spawning catapults in the bottom lane. This game's going good. So, again, what I was saying about Malfurion, you guys want to predict where the damage is gonna go. I'm gonna predict that this guy's probably gonna be taking damage over the next 15 seconds, so I'm gonna give him the healing. And yes, looks like he's just taking damage. You can see he's regenerating the damage he's taking pretty much straight away. It basically, what does the name of the game? Also give him the manas. I'm gonna give him some more. I'm actually gonna put this down there. Ooh, good fear. Get blown up, son! Get blown up, son! Is it heal? I mean, I can try. Oh god, we got wrecked. How did we get wrecked over there? Oh shit. Oh yeah, he multiplied the cooldown. The cooldown multiplied. God damn, that's how it was. That was the story of the game right there. So structures look fine. I'm gonna probably repair that fort. Not fort, the gate while I can. God damn it. God damn it. It was just a funny blow up on that Falstead though. You guys gotta admit that. Is she gonna take that camp? Did she take the talent? Did she do the thing? I don't think she did. She's not good. I'm gonna use that 25 damage percent damage amplification to deal the most damage. We'll be fine. Fine. Alright. Yeah. I'm gonna wait up. Are they gonna do the thing? Oh, cooldown in a very bad position. I'm gonna actually preemptively heal this thrall. It's gonna actually secure his. Actually, not. Are they doing the boss? There's no way he's their boss, right? God damn it, they did the boss. They did the thing. So, when should you use your Moonfire? You know, that's actually one of the very big questions, right? Like, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. Okay, that's good. Unstart the storm. So Moonfire should be used mainly to poke, right? It should never be used as your source of damage or anything like that, in my opinion at least. It should... Is he somewhere right there, like, right there or something? No. Probably got like an egg somewhere. Oh, he moved it, it's fine. He moved the nest, it's fine. Yeah, so it should be definitely used to poke. So like on maps like Curse's Hollow, like this map for Forehead Junction. I'm actually gonna rejoin with my team because look like they need me much more in the middle. So it should be used to poke to kind of, you know, to disrupt the objective and kind of, you know, give your friendlies time to get to you or kind of maybe extend the fight, because that's what Malfurion is best at, right? He's best at kind of extending the fight, just because his heals are very, very slow but very, very meaningful when they come. And next one is gonna go to my Xul if I can. There we go, there's the heal. So there's... Oh, he actually disrupted my ultimate there, and that's actually going to be a huge deal. Very nice counter-strike use. It's going to actually save our friendly Alarak from imminent death, and looks like we will be able to come up on top from that engagement, from that fight. There you go. I think he wanted mana, that's why he was next to me. So I'm gonna go probably nuke mid. Actually, mid should never be nuked. So I'm gonna go probably here. Nuke that. He's not there, right? No, he wasn't there. He just left a goddamn nest. Hello. Right. Let me give you some manas. Yeah. Xul and Alarak will be able to. Oh goddamn. Oh goddamn. I fucked up, boys. The nuke is coming down, which is going to destroy the tier 1 structures, but it's a 1-for-1 trade. Was that even 1-for-1? And they're missing a healer, which means this is going to be a really, really short fight, not in our favor. Nova going ham. She's not even going to kill that. Whoa. Oh, the blink is going to actually secure the kill, I think. Actually, pushing him back would have been better. Sorry, Alarak, but I think I would have outplayed you there. There comes the wolf, probably. Yeah. Actually, wolf did not go off, but the chain lightning did. Alright, no big deal. Can still win this game. I have to admit, I wasn't doing the best job with the Mew in this game. Alright, he's actually nuking this and taking damage. Good on you, Rehgar, good on you. I'm actually going to just pretend pull down me on that straight away. So nice nuke there, bro. I'm going to try to do something to him, but I cannot say that I will. Do 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 In the name of Scenarios. Alright. Hopefully I'm not gonna get wrecked, so as soon as I destroy this nest, I'm just gonna get out of here. Oh god, they did the boss. I gotta get out of here. I gotta do the thing. The running thing. Right. Can we regroup? Can we, like, all defend this or something? I feel like that's gonna be good. Alright, 14 seconds on my meal. I was actually a little bit too impatient there. Right. Innervates for everybody. Oh god. Let's give him the first heals. Looks like our throw will be slowed and actually be taking a lot of damage. The enemy Volstead falling already, but our Xul also falling in the process. I'm gonna try to heal her Nova. There you go, there's the heal. Here's that. While I can't, there's the silence. I'm actually going to try to heal our friend. The Alarak that's going to actually save him. No, it's not going to save him. But it was super close. Triple tap going on the enemy copy. That's going to do nothing. But we can still turn this fight around. We can still turn this fight around. There you go. There's your man. There's your heal. Okay, okay. Next one's going to Nova. Alright, 2 for 1 is not the worst, but not the best as well. Let's call down Mule right here. Guys, we need. What? We need it down here. Guys, I need you. I said the fort will be fine, but come here, I'm gonna give you manas. Yeah. So, what's he really good at? Really topping off his team. Like, when Malfurion's on your team, you probably won't ever need to go back for mana if he's a good Malfurion player. He's good at supporting you, and that's what I really meant. They're probably gonna do something like a boss or something, yeah. Yeah, they did the boss. God damn it. We were busy freaking defending and now they did the boss. An 8! He's gonna use the blink to get away, which is fine. That's the blink down. You never want to go behind the boss because you'll be taking damage like this troll is doing right now. I mean, I'll be able to heal him, but it's never a thing you want to do. You never want to go behind him just because he's living like this goo of damage that slows you and damages, actually quite heavily damages you, so. And they're actually wasting my mana right now because if they actually cared not to go behind it. Is that going to destroy it? If it's not going to destroy it, I'm going to destroy it. I'm going to call down Neo. Okay, I'm gonna call it down there. There goes mana. There goes the heal. Looks like they're just gonna go back to refill, but it's fine. Catch him! Catch him! Yeah. Come here, Zoro. Come here. We can do the thing. Come on. Oh my god. Okay, he mounted up. Yeah, he's fine. He's gonna be fine. The Xul did not react in time. And looks like our bottom is getting pushed while we were chasing that Gul'dan. And that's the enemy. It's fine. I can just take the damage, so it's fine. Enemy Abathur. Doing great job. Doing a great job at kind of like giving us a hard time right here. Like, I'm just gonna have to go back. Actually, I'm the worst target to go back, so Prince is gonna call down Mew right there to kind of keep it healthy. And Xul is gonna go and clean it up. There you go. There you go. That's the kind of stuff I need. I need that teamwork, you know what I mean? Can we bait or something? There we go. There's the root on the enemy Thrall, and that's going to be a kill for the friendly team. Can we go bottom and just finish? I don't think so. Hello? The enemy Thrall is not a Thrall, but Foss is going to be flying.
Collective action complete.
Okay. Yeah, we should definitely get these mercenaries so they can just keep pushing. Gonna give him the heal and give him the mana so he can clean up much faster. And the next heal is going for Thrall. So there's a little bit of an argument why you should pick the Wave Clear instead of Shadow's Clarity at level 1. And the whole reason is, what makes Malfurion OP is his trait. And if you just have more of it, just naturally makes sense, right?
You can just, you know, kind of throw out more, you kind of, you know, give the cooldown reduction more, which means, you know, it's just going to be much more powerful that way, right?
Right, so we do have a nuke. We picked up 3. We can definitely just go bottom. As we did pick up a kill on the enemy rig. Actually, no, we did not, but they were doing a boss. And that's actually going to maybe kill them. Oh, the goddamn heals me! The goddamn heals me. No, why did you do that? I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you, son of... You killed my Nova. Where are you? Alright, fuck him. Let's just go. Let's just go. I'm just gonna go. We need to do this before the enemy Abathur can push our top. Come on. Come. Yeah. Let's just put it on core. Let's just put it on core. Oh goddamn. Yeah, man! Yeah! All the nukes coming down now. And I think that's gonna be a good game. Boom, that's a good game. Enemy Abathur doing a good job at split pushing top, but we were just kind of good there. I used my ultimate right there on the Thrall, so he could not heal, he couldn't use any of his abilities, any of his bullshit. Oh, and the MVP at the end as well. Yeah. I'm always MVP. Yeah. Thrall was okay. Gazul was okay. Let's just go with the Thrall. I feel like he was better. but anyway, we are going to go over the build again. And just kind of justify why are we going for that build, and also what are the different choices in certain different situations. We are close to level 12, actually. Damn the experience now! Look at that. That stim pack paid to win. So we did much more healing than Rehgar. Actually, not much more. He actually did quite a lot of healing. Yeah, those Ancestrals do really help out his numbers. Oh, he went for an Earth Living Enchant. That's very interesting. Interesting. Anyway, so on level 1 we went for Shadow's Clarity, but again, the Moonburn talent is there if you need it. If you need any, so what it does, your Moonfire does increased damage, 100% more damage to non-heroic targets, right? So if you're missing something, like if a lot of your friendly team, like at least 2 members, don't have mana, they use something like a Brew from Chen or Energy Zarya or the Bullets for Tracer. If at least 2 members and you actually need a lot of Wave Clear, then sure, go for Moonburn. But in any other situation, I would still be a fan of Shadow's Clarity, just because it just spreads the love so much. Like, Innervate is what is so overpowered about Malfurion, and that's why you want to pick it up. That's why you want to just have as much of it as possible. Even if somebody is full mana, and you know that they're priority target because they're dealing damage or they're engaging, they need their cooldowns, go for your Shadow's Clarity and actually put the Innervate on them. On level 4, I went for Elune's Grace, basically increasing the range of all of our basic abilities by 30%. Level 7, we picked up Cooldown Mule. It's a really good talent on this map, just because when somebody does damage with Nuke and doesn't follow up with a push, it means that you can just heal it up. You know, the building, they just have to keep wasting nukes, right? If you're playing on any other map or the enemy team would have been actually very like CC heavy, I would have went for Cleanse. It just allows me to grant somebody unstoppable for 1 second. Level 10, I went for Twilight Dream, just because the enemy Rehgar and the enemy Thrall were engaging hard, but
Also, Falstaff was trying to fly behind us all the time, and that's why I wanted to punish him for that, not allowing to use him as his abilities, basically silencing him for 3 seconds and dealing some heavy damage. Level 13, I went for Shrink Ray, because again, that throw was engaging and I wanted to reduce the damage he was dealing to our friendlies. But again, you have a couple of choices here. You can go for Ice Block if there's something like a Triple Tap going your way, or a Pyroblast, or something, you know, just a channeled ability, or just to kind of uplift a little bit for focus from you. So for example, if you're getting focus, bam, you just pop the Ice Block, maybe the focus goes somewhere else, and then you might be living, you can just survive there to fight another day. Shrink Ray is really good, again, for reducing damage, so if they have like one very, very prime target, for example, it's a comp that's 100% focused on just supporting that Tracer or that Illidan, you want to just pick up the Shrink Ray, reduce their damage by 50%, and also slow down their movement, so they'll be easier to hit with skill shots, easier to kill, and stuff like that. Lifesteed is kind of a controversial talent here. Nearby heroes receives regrowth periodically, but it's not the full regrowth, it's just a heal over time. Why would you want that? Well, it's because it's to kind of uplift the whole strain of your healing, right? So you have the 20 second cooldown, which means that you, out of every 5 regrowths, you'll be getting pretty much one for free. Of course, you'll be getting the small initial heal, the small burst of heal, you know, the one that they get straight away when you cast the ability, but they will still be receiving the kind of healing well, kind of, you know, damage, kind of a health over time. I think it's good. So it is especially good if you did not pick up Tranquility at level 10. What it does, it heals kind of all allies around you for 10 seconds. If you went for Twilight Dream, this helps you a lot with your kind of group healing. Like, it's a lot of like Lily's Jugs, right? You throw out Q, it's the same as the Lifesteed. The person who's the lowest, they're gonna receive the healing of that Lifesteed. Very, very useful. It's just for the right situation. If you're struggling with healing and you do not pick up Tranquility, definitely go for Lifesteed. On level 16, I did go for Tenacious Roots, but another choice, again, if you're struggling with healing and you need a little bit less cooldown on that healing or those Tenacious Roots, you might want to go for Hardened Focus. It's strictly for the situations when you're not getting focused, you're not tanking a lot of damage, the enemy team is not recognizing you as the threat that you are. Then, if you're pretty confident you can keep your life above 80%, which is pretty much one skill shot from Nova or Zerto or something like that, then you might want to go for that. I'm actually a huge fan of Hardened Focus just because I like to stay healthy in the game as a Malfurion, so I'm a huge fan of this. But in that particular game, I was actually getting focused by the Falstead, by the Gul'dan, so I knew that Tenacious Roots is going to be much better of a choice. What it does, it basically increases the overall area of the root, right? So the grass grows further. It also lasts on the ground for 25% longer. And also, this is going to be increasing the root duration by 0.5 seconds. Really, really good. Again, it's up to you. You either cut off a third from your cooldown if you're staying above 80%, or you can just kind of increase the duration of the root and kind of maybe zone and area for a little bit longer. Really up to you, up to what you want. Level 20, I did go for Storm Shield, which kind of allowed me to save that Nova, I think. No, yeah, it saved the Nova from the Gul'dan damage, but then Falstaff was like just kind of running away like a little bitch, and he just kind of threw his Hammerang behind him and killing the Nova, actually. Just because, kind of, again, exposing what Malfurion is not good at. He's not good at mitigating burst damage, but he's good sustaining the friendlies. So, two choices here. If you went for the Twilight Dream, you want to get a good Twilight Dream like on 4 people and kind of ensure the win in the team fight, you might want to go for Blink. You Bolt of the Storm, you blink right into the enemy team, press your R, the team fight should pretty much be won. I went for Storm Shield just because the enemy team had a lot of burst damage. They had the damage from Gul'dan, which I could mitigate with the shields. And it's just super strong, I felt like, against that composition. Also allowed me to maybe just keep somebody just alive, just to basically, for my Q to come off of the cooldown and allow me to save them that way. So that's the build. The link is going to be down in the description to the write-up of this build. I did edit it towards the requirements that I heard from the Reddit community. I really appreciate everybody stopping by, everybody dropping a like, or even, you know, a dislike, and just saying, okay, you suck, you play this game horribly, I prefer the Moonfire build. Just do that if you feel like that's the thing you want to do, and if you can actually say to me, this is better because this, because the stats say it that way, then sure, but just don't come in there and just say, you suck, that's it. That doesn't really help anybody. It just maybe strokes your ego a little bit because you think that you're more intelligent than me, but you're not making guides, so how good is that to all of us? Not really good in any way. But anyway, I'm gonna stop being salty, and I'll see you guys in the next video.